Well, St Mirren started the weekend bottom of the table. They faced a trip to Rugby Park to play a Kilmarnock side yet to lose under new boss Gary Locke. Commentary comes from Paul Mitchell.
Kilmarnock are without the suspended Darryl Westlake, who's replaced by Ross Barber, while Aleksei Eremenko starts in place of Chris Chandler. Two changes from the side that drew at Motherwell. Gary Teal has the rare pleasure of naming an unchanged winning 11. It's the same side that took all 3 points from Hamilton Accies, thanks to a goal by Stephen Thompson. Well, a minute's applause in memory of Andy King, the Kilmarnock right back from the 1965 title winning side. The European appearance record holder too for Kilmarnock, who's passed away at the age of 72. Long throw, it's not particularly well defended, breaks down onto Stephen Thompson. Thompson trying to get away from Barber, pulls the ball round. Deflected wide, Lee Ashcroft it looked like. Well, Stephen Thompson certainly appeared to catch Ross Barber here while he was trying to battle for the ball. Takes a nice touch and it's well deflected. Just too strong. Chris Johnson brushed away by Tesselaar. Tesselaar, the left fullback, gets it back again. Away from O'Hara. It's a lovely little ball across onto Deaton. Rattles the crossbar and it will work out to be a corner. Great technique here from James Deaton, watched it all the way. Into the middle it goes, McGuinness. McGuinness leads it back, Johnson, that's brilliantly done. Richards with a save and cleared by Naismith. Chris Johnson, great feat. McGuinness held it up well, moved away from Tesselaar. Lovely little ball inside, just too straight for the shot. Well, Gary Locke still seeing his side at 0-0, still unbeaten as Kelly Boss. That's harsh on Gary. It was O'Hara, play on. Mallon gets it away, chance for Deaton. Knocked down by Sampson and pushed away. Well, the referee, Steve McLean, allowed play on here. O'Hara did get the ball, did take the man out too. And in the end, James Deaton did get a shot away for the visitors. Mallon's corner. High in there, it's not particularly well cleared. Pascali battling for it with Naismith. Only as far as Goodwin. Back into the mix it goes. Kelly across. Kilmarnock struggling to clear here. Jenner is offside. This won't count. Sampson couldn't keep it out in the big centre half. Was offside when the header comes in from Jim Goodwin. That's a good call from the officials. Alan Gow continued, thought he'd score. It won't count. Kilmarnock seeking their 10th league win of the season. St Mirren seeking their 7th. Nice play. On to Johnson. Here's McGuinness. Josh McGuinness pulls the ball back. Lee Miller! The substitute has scored. And it's the first Kilmarnock goal for Lee Miller. 3 minutes to play. Great football from Kilmarnock. McGuinness played it across. That's a real striker's finish from Lee Miller. Knew where the corner was and found it. Kick we're taking short, no need to hurry things. Chris Johnson though sees a gap, goes for it on the left foot. Matt Richards saving with his foot. And St Mirren were desperate to try and get the ball back here, but they left an almighty gap and Chris Johnson just pressed the accelerator and almost made it two.
It's not about me, it's about the players, and the players have been fantastic since I've been put in interim charge, and you know, I couldn't be happier with the players. Their effort and commitment's been fantastic. You know, they're working really hard, but they're looking organised, you know, and we look dangerous when we go forward as well. So you know, I couldn't be happier. It's enormous credit to the players because they're the ones that are getting us results.
We've got to concentrate on ourselves. See, we've got to be as positive as we can. And I say the performance today, I say I think we merited to get him away, come away from here with something, but unfortunately we've not, and again we just need to, it's up to me to now pick up the boys, get their belief back, and to say to go up to St Johnstone next week and try and get 3 points.
Well, Mark, about time Lee Miller scored his first goal for Kilmarnock, but not great timing if you're a St Mirren fan.
No, it's surprising that Lee Miller's just scored his first goal, that is a surprise. St Mirren, they're in a,
a bit of trouble just now. Not good if you're a fan of theirs just now. They don't want to be cut adrift, and the points are starting to go against them. Had plenty of chances to win that game, that's the thing.
Well, let's have a look at the chances. Barry, friend of the show, Stephen Thompson. What was there? Dare I say it, a slight stamp here?
Yeah, I mean, I said, to be fair to Tom, I just think he's trying to fight for the ball. And as Mark said, there's no reaction for the Kilmarnock players.
Yeah.
So they're not thinking anything of it either. I just told him to maybe try to fight. And
that's
looks,
a telltale sign. If Kilmarnock players protest, then you can see he didn't mean it.
And this was a fantastic strike from James
Davis. It was nearly Van Basten from back in the day. But the biggest thing St Mirren have had this season, and it's been evident, is scoring goals has been a problem.
Yeah.
And that's why they are where they are. And that's a hard thing to... That's a hard thing to get integrated into your side, but
no doubt to be the offside here. Do they have enough substance, Barry? Do you feel to stay up?
Well, they've got some good. They've got experience as well, you know. They've got some good players there, and like Stephen Thompson and like Jim Goodwin is experienced at the back as well. And it's going to be hard. It's going to go right to the wire, I think, with the three that's down there at the minute. And I think it'll be really exciting to watch who is going to fold and who's going to come out strong.
And Mark, quick mention of Gary Locke, 6 games unbeaten. Mm. It's working, isn't it?
Of course it's working, but that's what you want when a new manager comes in. You want a spark, you want to liven things up. He's achieved that with the same group of players, almost in the top 6.
Okay.